at least now the conversations have begun. At least questions are being raised. And to the women who haven't spoken about what they've been through, would you like to say anything?
You know, I'd like to correct you here. And I corrected a few people who started some petition.
Mm-hmm.
And they said, we are going to get all the men out. And I said, I'm sorry. Your narrative is wrong.
Mm.
So everybody has to be very careful of what the narrative is. It's not just the women.
Hmm.
We have to say that is every human being going to come out?
Right.
Whether it's man, whether it's woman, and let's touch upon the LGBTQ+.
Right.
Let's
agreed.
Not forget.
Yeah.
But because it's not being discussed correctly, people are not aware of it.
Hmm.
We are a very small bubble of educated in that scene. We are in this scenario. How is it going to reach deeper ends of this country?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
We are sitting here in this fancy studio in Bombay, in the middle of this entertainment industry, blah, blah, blah. It has to... And we are fighting with educated people, trying to convince them firstly that it's not a woman versus man thing. So if we don't take this forward, the conversations correctly, and if people don't come and make sense, show your anger.
Yeah.
Show your rage. Because if you're not angry and you're not, you should be angry. You should be ashamed of yourself if you're not angry. Even if today it could be, tomorrow it could be anybody. Today it could be your own children, yeah, that this is happening to.
Yeah.
And then they turn out to be predators because of the damage done to them, or they turn out to be victims and survivors. What are we doing? So the narrative has to change. We've only got some kind of LGBTQ law now after so much fighting.
In
but what it took that community. So if today men, women don't stand up together and empower each other.
Yeah.
This thing now that men should not complain.
Hmm.
Are be a man.
Be a man.
Right.
No, be a man and stand up for your women and for yourselves. And for society, for your children, be a man. Stand up for your wife. Stand up for your sister. Stand up for your mother.
Yeah.
Stand up for your daughter. That is be a man. This thing of being strong. I'm so sick of hearing this tag that I'm strong, I'm strong, I'm strong. And I never ever get vulnerable like this. Ever. I'll howl in my house. I'll never show this face. I'll never ever show this side, you know? And I'm not crying to get pity out of anything, but I wake up and I go to sleep so disturbed by everything that's happening, okay? And I have to use that rage and anger correctly, okay? I have to use it correctly. I'm not going to go out there and be, this is out of frustration, it is out of a release, you know? I know so many men survivors that I've spoken to in the past few days. Yesterday, I was with someone on the phone for 3 hours. My first thing was, I don't want to know names. Because God knows I'm definitely going to know them.
Yeah.
Okay? So I don't want to know.
Hmm.
But you want help, I'll listen to you. It takes so much out of you. I had to inspire myself. People say, you're an inspiration. Aray, you know, it's very great. Yeah. There's a side of me, I'm a Leo. You know, there's that side of me that's like... You know, you know, that thing. You know, we have
the
that.
The strong dominating side.
But there's a side of me that's like, the fact that you think I'm an inspiration, I have to inspire myself to get out of bed to go and do a mundane chore like cook for my dog or to cook for my parents or cook for myself or go and wash bartans, man. That seems like a Herculean task because I empathize with everybody. I'm lucky that nothing worse has happened to me, but far worse has happened to others that are around me right now. And I hear those stories and I hear it from men. Boys are bawling, but they can't come out and cry. Women are supposed to be like this. We are supposed to be like this. We're supposed to cry. The fact that I've cried, I'll give you a biggest example of the hypocrisy. Had I done this in Bigg Boss, if I had cried, everybody knows what my story was.
Hmm.
Had I cried, okay, I would have won that show.
Yeah.
You think I didn't know that? I've had a friend in Bigg Boss from season one. I've watched every season, right up until my season, and then I stopped watching. I didn't even watch my own season because I know what really went on and I know what is edited and shown to you guys. This is not a movie. It's not a Balaji TV serial. It is not a goddamn Bollywood movie. It is not a reality TV show. Get the f***, make the f*** up. This is real shit. The emotions I went through were real shit. If I have to out that guy, his mother would be embarrassed.
Yeah.
Okay? I have gone and I have apologized to his mother. Why did I apologize to his mother? Because no, this is upbringing. You respect someone no matter what she has said to me. My parents have raised me to be different. If your mother was hurt, if your brother was hurt, I will apologize. It doesn't make me a smaller person.
Yeah, true.
It doesn't. I know my truth, but people are judgmental out there. Because no, they want you to cry and say that, you know, but he touched my leg. He wanted to kiss me. He was the first one to touch my leg under the blanket. Main bolu, you want to know the truth, but get out of reality TV.
Yeah.
Get out of movies. Get out of this image that we've created. Let's clean up the star's image. Let's call them out.
Hmm.
What is the image cleaning that's happening in Bollywood? What do you think? In fashion, Jessica Lal, they have... Who came and stood? How many witnesses were there? And how long did it take her to... I expect the fashion industry to come out for this and say this happened. Nobody... Nobody, everyone is as weak as... No, everything is not Bollywood, everything is not a TV serial. And in this country, we have made cricket, Bollywood and TV serials, everything. The rest of... Nobody matters. And aake rona dona kar do, bas. What is Anirban doing? What are half these people? Mazaak bana ke rakha hai.
Right, Diandra, like you said, this movement is not sexist. It's not about man versus women. We urge all you men, women, LGBTQ plus community to come forward. Tell us your story because we are here, we are listening, and this movement, this conversation needs to keep going. Thank you, Diandra, for joining us and doing what you've done, for calling out names fearlessly and being the bold you are.
Yeah, thank you. But I wonder what's going to happen off me. So, if something ever does happen, and you're attending my funeral, please make sure that you make a noise and be as loud as I've been. Be as fearless as I've been. Put me in some designer outfit because some, God knows this industry, they owe me some, you know, everybody's so fake. So some fancy outfit.
We need
who,
women.
Who, what? And of course, don't forget that, you know, if I've died an actress or at least a wannabe actress who's come for like publicity and we're doing this for publicity, blah, blah, blah. You know what? I'm going to be a star. So you make sure that you put some fancy ass shades on me, guys.
Don't worry, you're not going
and
anywhere.
And please announce the conspiracy theory because I'm going out kicking and f***ing screaming.
But we need more women like you, so thank you for joining us on our show.
I had too much coffee, right?
Planet Bollywood News, Monday to Friday at 7 p.m. Only on Zoom.